Go Craig.
Go Craig.
Go ahead, Craig dance.
Let me dance.
Not you, get out of the way. Go ahead, Craig.
Go Craig.
Go ahead, Craig, do your cricket dance. Craig.
Love is crazy.
There's so many different ways that love can make you feel. You feel hurt, you feel healed, make you feel like you're on the top of the world, make you feel like you are the lowest of the low. I'm a lover boy. You know, I love love. And I've always had a complicated relationship with love until I met my baby. Sometimes people come in your life when you feel like you're done. And that person will just stroll right in. Like, where the fuck you been at? Where have you been when I was going through that shit? It's crazy because it tests you. Because now you have to make a decision. You are then called to be present in that moment. Because you can be present or you can let your past be the reason why you don't get the love that you deserve. Love heals all things. She is the one that I have been waiting for to give all of this man to. And all that was asked of me was to be present. Being present in life will allow you to really receive everything that is in front of you because love isn't as complicated as we make it. And trust me, I'm still learning. Every day, choosing love. I'm still learning.
My sister.
Don't hurt nobody.
I feel like boys are left behind. Hear me out. All right. I feel like boys get left behind when it comes to love and nurturing in their early stages because of how intense and rough manhood is. Ah, we're men. We're men to be a man. Ah, no, we're fucking human. And a lot of people make the mistake to think that we don't need just as much love as anyone else. Just think about this. The foundation of love comes from your parents. So first, it's their job to instill self-love, which means that it is their job to see you, to nurture you, to inspire you, to uplift you, to make you feel like you are enough. Just you being you is enough to be loved and to receive love. The next step is how to give love, not just receive it, but give it. Because down the line, How are you able to be the foundation or create love when you don't know how to give it? But it starts in that motherfucking house. And a lot of times people just think that we'll be all right. We don't need it, but we do. That love, that nurturing, we need it. We need it. Mama, you who gave birth to me, and helped me grow. Mama is good. Mom, I feel like you're not ready to hear how I really feel about this whole thing. Okay, and I don't want you to take anything the wrong way or feel like I'm calling you a bad parent or that you're a bad person. That's not the case, okay? But you're asking me a question. So I'm gonna be honest, okay? You know, as crazy as it sounds, you don't really know me. And hear me out, like, you know Craigie, you know little Craig, you know I'm alive. You know, like, basic things, you know, but you don't know me. You don't know all this took to get here. You don't know my path, my journey, my true likes, my aspirations, the things that I think about, like, you don't really know me. You don't call me. And yeah, like, the phone goes both ways, da da da, but like, you my parent, like, you my mother, you my mom. Like, you don't call your son? That's a little crazy. You don't call me, you don't check up on me to see how I'm doing. Like, really check on me, really talk to me, see what's going on in my mind. Like, not just checking a box and, you know, hey, how you doing? You good? School good? Cool? Okay, cool. Nah, like, really talking to me. You don't do that. When was the last time you actually called me even? Like, last year. You know? I'm just like, what do you expect from me? Like, I'm trying to figure out how is it a surprise to you that, like, we just got a surface transactional relationship. All we do is talk about money. Like, the only valuable thing we talk about is money. So, of course, it seems like that's all there is, because that's all there is. As far as, like, life stuff that I could carry, that I could, you know, character stuff that I could have, I never got none of that stuff from you. What? Okay. All right. You did your best. So it's all fine because you did your best, right? Like, I'm not even talking about what you did. What you did, I'm talking about what you didn't do. And that's what you got to say? Like, you did your best and you're sorry? You don't even know what you're sorry for. You did your best?
you did your best. Okay. You did your best. You think I care if you did your best? That's the problem with parents. I gave you food. I gave you clothes. I gave you shelter. That's what you're supposed to do as a parent. I didn't ask to be here. You brought me here. And you talking about you did your best. So let's give it up. You did your best. Yeah. Round of applause for you because you did your best. What about what I needed? I needed my mother, but you weren't there because of work. Okay. But I see you give your time to everybody else. You did your best. And even when you're home, you're not home. So what do you have to say to that? You did your best. You know, I see you give love and attention to everybody else but me when I needed it. And I feel like it's because there's some sort of resentment. Not because I did anything, but towards the man who made me everything that I am today. And whatever shit y'all got going on between y'all, that's between y'all. But to put that on your son, that's crazy. Because who else am I supposed to be like? Who else am I supposed to be like, huh? The only man who raised me, who put everything in me to be who I am. You did your best. This shit would be different if you wasn't comparing relationships. But you upset at the man who gave me everything? You did your best. And you're jealous of our relationship? He built that shit. You know why? Because that's what parents are supposed to do. She did her best. All right. I don't think you really wanted to be there. That's what I'm realizing. You don't want to be there for me, but you did your best. Love was conditional. You showed me love through gifts or throwing parties and celebrations, but what about that nurturing? You did your best, right? So that's it? That's it. You don't know me. You don't know your son. Isn't that crazy? Isn't that insane? You did your fucking best. I'm your son. I needed you. But you was too busy focused on other shit, on everybody else other than your number one priority, which should have been me. So you know what? You got it. I'll take that L. I will take and deal with the fact that you didn't want to be there. That's just it. Call it what it is. But don't fucking sit here and tell me it was work, it was this or that, when you made time for other shit. No, you can't do that. And you know, I think it's better this way. Because I've always felt like a burden. Like I was too much, even though I barely asked for shit. But what I require is too much. So you know what? I'm a release you from your duties as a parent. Continue to be everyone else's fucking mother. Cause I'll be damned if I let my kids be neglected by their grandmother for no reason, just because they had some other shit to do. You had some other shit to do. I'd be damned. I'd be damned if I have to fucking beg you to do your fucking job as a parent. And if that's the case, why have kids? Why? have kids. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. Why have a child if you aren't capable or willing to get through your own shit so that you can do your job and be there for your child? Nah, it's okay. I'm gonna be all right. I'm gonna be all right because I got this far. I'm here. I'm about to go on and do so many great things in my life. And I've realized only a few people are gonna be on my ship. And I can't say you on that ship with me. As sad as that may be, as cruel as that may sound, I don't have any use for people who just want to be there for the celebration, but not my journey. No. So go ahead, be free. I release you. I don't need it. I don't need it. And even if you were capable of doing it right now, I wouldn't want it, because you're 24 years too late. And that's so sad. And it might be sad to fucking hear. It might be so heavy and painful for you to hear all these things that I'm saying, but imagine what it feels like. Just imagine. Just imagine. So it's okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm fine. I'm great. And I'll be fine. I don't need you. I don't need you. I'm
good. Yeah. I'm fine. No. It's okay. Great conversation. And I gotta go. I gotta head to class. So I'll talk to you later. We'll talk later. We will. I'm okay. All right. Love you. Bye.
Won't you take care of Mama?
Leave the rug alone. 7. 8. 9. 10. Yay! Yeah, Craig said his number.
Listen. I know it hurts. You don't know shit. You don't know shit. Because while you out here walking around like shit ain't fucked up, like we ain't hurting, I gotta sit here and deal with that pain by myself. Not you. Me. You leave it to me.
Look, man, I'm sorry. Okay? I'm sorry. I'm fucking sorry, man. I'm sorry.
Fuck that. And fuck you.
Hear me out.
Fuck you, man.
What if she's the one?
I don't think you're hearing me.
You know she's the one.
I can't do it again.
You know she is.
I don't care who it's for.
You know she is. Because I know she is.
I'm not doing it. I'm not. It hurts too much.
Man, I want us to be free from all this pain that we've been carrying. We gotta let it go.
No.
We gotta make space for something new.
No.
We gotta make space for her.
No.
What do we have to lose?
Nigga, are you hearing me? The fuck you mean, what do we have to lose? I don't got it in me no more, man.
We gotta let it go.
I can't, and I won't, man. I won't let us be hurt again, man. I can't do it. Somebody's gotta protect us. Somebody's gotta do it.
Come on, man.
Man, I'm tired. I can't.
I'm tired too.
I can't.
But for once, man, let's just leave with love.
I'm not doing it.
Let's give her everything. Because she deserves it. For all that she is, she wants us. She wants us. You know she the one.
She is.
How can I ask her to be with me if I'm not willing to be open? If I'm not willing to give her all of who I am? We got to. I need you to open up fully for her because she deserves
it. And as much as I want to, I can't help but think, what if it ends? As much as I want to open up to her, I can't help but think, what happens when she doesn't want me anymore? What happens?
I'm not even gonna let you go on that tangent. She's not. Because that's not her. She loves us for us. And we love her. You love her. Come on, man. Let's give her everything because she's worth it. And I promise you, I will never let anything happen to you again. Because we in this together. It's us. All of us together. Can you open up for me one more time? I need you, man. Come on. Open up one more time.
Fabulous to see you all here. Had such
just
a crowd.
Because of
to see you all here.
Peeling my second whip, stealing, putting second hand kills in my residence. Healed all my brethren with a seal, we can't let you in. Medicine, I put the effort in, still burn that effigy. Odorous, I'm sober, just as little as they let me. Mama, wipe your tears, I'm fighting titans, can't invite you here. Poetic license, fear from the mic, my chest too tight to steer. Chest lessons, blood letting flood when the night is clear. I ain't give a fuck till my lungs had to fight for it. Glaring, staring, numb, therapist, had a life to spare. Snatched me by the eye, said I'ma fight whether I like or not. And then she told me reasons why, but that's the private part.